This video is brought to you by my super hot Patreon supporters. I was really into Goosebumps as a kid. For my 10th birthday, I received a replica of the Haunted Mask from the book cover. I threw together my entire costume to accommodate it. I was going for a suburban Halloween special vibe, you know? There was a lot of nuance going into it coming from an 11-year-old. I took to the streets with my little brother and our parents, and I found it that none of the other kids in my neighborhood knew who I was. They didn't read the Goosebumps books like I did. It was almost a complete bust until one of the parents answering the door freaked out. They're like, "Oh my god, I used to read those books as a kid," and I was like, "Yes." It made the sweaty, uncomfortable, stinky, expensive mask worth it. Just one single comment made my entire night. Another year I went trick-or-treating with a girl I had a crush on, and we went to the rich neighborhood. One house had the entire front porch tarped off. There was a giant crowd of kids huddled around it. "This looks interesting," I told myself, and I went in to investigate. Turns out, the homeowners put a strobe light at the back of the porch, and someone was sitting in front of it on a chair. We couldn't see their face, everyone was too scared to approach them and get candy. I wanted to impress the girl I was with, so I decided to just march right on in. Kids held my hand as I slipped deeper into the porch, and I reached for the candy bowl. Then the figure slumped over. It was a scarecrow, and no one had any real reason to be spooked. "Hey guys, look! It's not real, it's just a doll! Come grab some candy!" Every year we'd stop at my uncle's house and he'd give us some weird stuff. One year he gave me and my little brother some toilet paper. Another he gave us an ear of corn. One infamous year, he handed us skinned deer legs from his hunting trip. The year that I took that girl out, he gave us waffles. I gave her half my Eggos. She was having like this contest with her older brother to see who could get better loot. The Eggo waffles served as a tiebreaker, so she won that year. My freshman year of high school
was the last year I still felt like a kid.
And I went trick-or-treating with a girl I had the biggest crush on ever. We went through her neighborhood, which was pretty much in the middle of nowhere. There weren't a whole lot of houses, and many of them just sat alone on weeded over properties with their lights out. The moon peeked out behind the trees' bare branches. There was a lot of walking along dirt roads. The streets were mostly empty that year because it was like on a Friday and everyone was at some party or something like that. Orange streetlights, stray cats, just hanging out and talking and stuff. We walked down a super isolated backwoods path to get into another neighborhood, and we could have sworn that we heard footsteps behind us and we panicked. Although to be honest, it was probably nothing, you know? Not many houses were open that year, actually. We just went over to her house, we watched The Conjuring, and I remember thinking it was remarkably unscary based on what I heard about it. All things considered, I think that was probably the best Halloween I'd ever had. The following year, I was just too cool for trick-or-treating. I went to a concert in Boise. I saw One OK Rock, or One Oak Rock, or however you pronounce it, I don't care. Neck Deep, who are actually doing a once-in-a-lifetime performance as their alter ego Slipknot. Sleeping with Sirens, and All Time Low. After the concert was over, while everybody was leaving, they played the Marilyn Manson version of This Is Halloween over the speakers, and the entire crowd stopped what they were doing and they started singing. Halloween 2016, I hung around downtown Boise with a new friend of mine at the time. We walked through some record stores, we made our way through the spooky old neighborhoods in town. He had a costume on, he was dressed up as Eleven from Stranger Things. I did not have a costume, I didn't get the memo. He wanted to go trick-or-treating, but I was like, "I'm in my street clothes, I can't trick-or-treat, I'm 17, like, no one likes 17-year-olds trick-or-treating. I don't want to add insult to injury by not dressing up." So we found a compromise. I just walked around and I played ukulele at people's doorstep and they gave me candy. It was actually a lot of fun and an amazing memory. I guess this video is a little bit weird because I don't have one great story of trick-or-treating and Halloween and stuff. For me, Halloween is just a collection of images, scenes, events, and people. Sneaking around the backwoods of small town Idaho in the middle of the night with my crush under a giant moon thinking that a real-life serial killer is hiding in the bushes besides me, that's Halloween to me. Exploring neighborhoods, making friends, that's Halloween too. Old family traditions, Halloween. I'm a legal adult now, so I can't go trick-or-treating. I can't sneak around neighborhoods in the middle of the night on Halloween because that would kind of worry some parents. I can't do a lot of the things I used to do, and that kind of sucks. I used to be bummed out about it, but now I kind of had a bit of an epiphany. You see, I'm not on the receiving end of Halloween anymore. So that means that it's my responsibility to be on the giving side. It's now my job to take everything I loved about my Halloween memories and help the next batch of kids create their own experiences too. I am free to set up tarps on my front porch and a strobe light and jump out last minute. I can give any future nieces or nephews rolls of toilet paper for Halloween. The possibilities are endless, you know? There's so much to do. If you're watching this and you're young enough to participate in Halloween and trick-or-treating and stuff, enjoy it. spend some time with friends, going on adventures, take a dark and spooky path to get home. If you're my age and you're too old to finally do that stuff, use your imagination and see what you can do to make every Halloween memorable for somebody else. Even if you have to scare them half to death and make their parents mad, they'll look back on it and smile when they're older. Have a happy Halloween, be safe, be smart, stay spicy. Also, I got some Patreon shoutouts to do. Otto Zaguala wants to listen to Rock with Your Grandma. Harry Phillips, who's using their shoutouts for self-promotion, wants you to go listen to their awful cover of The Middle by Jimmy Eat World. Link in the description, by the way. Also, special thanks to Daddy Cthulhu, Ollie A, Frankie Blue, Gabby Taylor, and Spencer Purcell. These kids are the best, and I'm super fortunate to have the good vibes on my Patreon. You can join too by clicking the link, this one right here. Happy spooky season.